Hello and welcome to SOW Summit 2020. This time around our panel discussion, we're going to talk about gaming and what's next. We're joined today by Mr. Vikash Mittersen. He's the chairman and managing director of Nazara Technologies, a company in the mobile game space operating in many countries. He comes with a vast experience spanning over 30 years in businesses in multiple sectors. He's the founder and president of India Business Group, a chamber of commerce which connects with all segments and sectors of business. Mr. Vikash, thank you for agreeing to be with us today. Let me kickstart by asking you, what made you realize that you need to step into the gaming industry, and what's the story behind Nazara Technologies?
Let me go back to where we began. Nazara was Nazara.com once, and there was a time when we were into many things. Nazara was into films. I mean, it's a big website. We had about 10 items there. And then came the crash of 2002. It was a worldwide crash.
Yep.
As it is, we didn't have any revenues, but any chance of revenue disappeared after that. So the only area that we found that we could make some money or some revenue was games. So we shut everything else. It was mobile games. We have always been mobile games only. We shut everything else, focused on mobile games. So 2003, 2004 was a very dark period in the business sector all over the world.
Correct.
At that point of time, Vodafone wanted a game supplier because they were doing games all over the world. They didn't have somebody in India. So they approached us. They knew that we are already trying to do games. They approached us and said that, would you like to work together with us?
Brilliant.
We said that, okay, we can try, but we really don't understand games. So what they did was they assigned two people from Vodafone who would come and sit in our office and teach us how to make games for the mobile phones. So that's the beginning. So we were like among the first players in the mobile games business. Direct from the horse's mouth, the customer would sit in our office and teach us.
Wow.
And then there was no looking back.
Yeah, what a phenomenal start that was, Mr. Vikash.
Yeah.
So moving forward, let me ask you, Mr. Vikash, the gaming industry has grown exponentially over the last decade or so. You know, it now is a very dense industry. How can startups join this industry and find success considering there's so much of competition around?
You know, it only looks like so much of competition. In actuality, there is space for at least 50 more companies in gaming, especially mobile gaming. The market is huge and it is like almost doubling every year. More and more players are coming. So the startup needs to decide what space they want to take within the gaming industry. Everybody comes with their own uniqueness.
Correct.
Their own ideas.
Correct.
Their own products which stand up besides, you know, apart from the rest. So while you're part of a large play, you still have your niche. So the important part here is that create your own niche. Come into the gaming industry, but with your own niche. Could be the marketing side, could be the technology, could be the very basic idea itself of the game that you want to produce. And also you need not produce hundreds of games. Just two beta games can capture the market for you. So the market is not yet overwhelmed. There is a lot of space for new players, and I always encourage new players.
That's
so
lovely.
They don't really add to the competition. They add to make the market bigger.
Bigger, correct. And what an interesting perspective to look at with that thought. Shifting gears, may I ask you now, Mr. Vikash, what makes India a great gaming market, and what is the future of gaming in India? You just stole that. You know, it still has space for 50 more. So what do you see? Yep. Where do you see this industry going?
To start with, we have a population of online under 25 population, and this everybody speaks about, of almost 300 million people. No, 500 million people, almost. And each of them is a potential customer. Each of them is a potential player. Most of them are already playing games. So that is where the startup should see as a market. It's big enough for everybody, as I just said. So what is the what did you ask? Just tell me again.
What is the future of gaming in India?
Yeah, the future of gaming. You understand that China had become the biggest gaming country in the world.
Yes.
Had become, I have said. India is catching up very fast, and China is in trouble, as we all know, in every sector that they operate in. So we have a great opportunity to capture the gaming market. And then India is what India is, with all these youngsters bubbling with enthusiasm. How can gaming not succeed? It has a great, great future going forward.
So definitely a lot of space for a lot of companies to step in and be a part of the gaming industry.
Yeah.
Mr. Vikash, let me now ask you that you are the founder and president of India Business Group, which is a chamber of commerce which connects various segments of business. Can you tell us a little bit about it and how does it help startups?
So let me give you a little lateral background.
Sure, sir.
I am a guy with a lot of initiatives that I want to do.
Correct.
I have started India Business Group, which is a chamber of commerce. No new chamber of commerce has come into being in so many years, in tens of years. So we had that mover advantage. The other chambers of commerce are all big, old. They're run by mostly by committees.
Correct.
Here, it's just my decision that matters. So we are very nimble. We can change track. And it's my background and my current situation is not just Chamber of Commerce, not just Nazara Technologies. I'm an author. I've published 3 books. I'm a radio jockey.
Correct.
I have every Friday evening show.
Yes.
Which, of course, is suspended during COVID. But I've done over 100 interviews on radio. I'm an honorary consul for Republic of Mali. So I have completely opened up myself to do whatever comes to me, whatever new comes. So as a chamber, it was no big shakes to start a chamber. And now it's been 8 years. It's doing very well. We have over 1,000 paid members. And we reach out to about 50,000 people in the country.
Wow.
So we are set. We are growing. We are doing a lot of initiatives. In fact, COVID has helped us a lot. We completely changed. We completely pivoted. The moment March came and the lockdown happened, I realized that we are never going to be the same.
Yeah.
Because all our events used to be real world events.
Correct.
Meeting, greeting, talking, restaurants, hotels. I realized immediately that this is over. And it won't come back for 2 years. So by now, we would have perished.
Correct.
Any chamber which doesn't not able to do its work or to meet people. So we pivoted it. We were only a Bombay-based chamber. We tied up with, in the last 6 months, we have tied up with over 40 chambers around the world. So that our members can interact and get business from the chambers and their members. So we went online. We became a digital chamber rather than the real world chamber. And it's worked very well for us. Membership is growing rapidly now, seeing what all that we can do and we are doing. And for the members, the chamber is only interested in helping members grow.
Okay.
And we have a lot of such things happening where every member feels that he's being paid personal attention. I myself have a Monday morning mentoring session. And any member can book it. I normally am booked for about 2 months in advance. Every Monday morning, there is a mentoring session where they send me their background in advance. And then they ask me live questions. And it's been a successful journey in that because a lot of people have come back and said, even after a year, that you changed us, you changed our business. we are no longer in trouble, we are growing fast.
Wow. So
that is the whole idea of this chamber and my personal mentoring.
Brilliant.
There are many facets that we do.
Yeah. So it's with growth being in its main center, with its focus, and then there's mentoring and personal connect,
yes,
and cross connection and networking. So that's beautiful to know, Mr. Vikash. And you know, you're an author, you're a radio jockey, you've been the spearheader of many a first. What is the advice you'd like to give our entrepreneurs out there?
It depends on the entrepreneur also. I don't give general advice. If somebody wants advice, they could talk to me about themselves. What are they currently doing? What is the background? What do they want to do? What do they want to achieve? So it need not be just a gaming company.
Correct.
Or a gaming entrepreneur. It can be anybody.
Any business.
Any business. Once even a farmer came online and wanted to talk to me to ask about how he can grow his field, what he's doing.
Hmm.
So it's now become an open book. Anybody can come and talk to me. They have to just book it in advance.
Wow. Thank you, Mr. Vikash. And that kind of comes us, gets us close to the end of this panel discussion. But the last couple of questions before we wind up. You know, you were just telling that how you've adapted India Business Group and you and members involved have adapted themselves to the entire pandemic. So what were the initiatives, if you can briefly share with us, what were the initiatives taken by you to help startups and entrepreneurs to deal with this entire pandemic COVID-19 situation in the past few months?
So as I said, it's now all digital. A lot of people are in trouble because they have real world businesses.
Yeah.
Which almost all stopped. And a lot of them are on their last legs. So what we do as a chamber is if somebody is doing a shop, let us say, we put them in touch with relevant members who can promote them, get them business, show them how to change. It's not just me showing or mentoring. Our members have also got trained how to mentor. And we have a very dynamic chamber.
Correct.
All members are out there to help the other members. So during COVID, this has accelerated. It's got growth. Our members are really eager to help the other members. And so that has made COVID, almost defeated COVID in that sense. May not have defeated its actual journey, but the impact is not so bad for me, my chamber, and our members.
What a creative way to deal with this pandemic, sir. Adapt and grow, adapt and grow.
Yeah.
And that brings me to the final question for this panel discussion. What do you think is a success mantra? Is there any? Are there any?
There are always, always. And you know, I tell my members some things which may have nothing to do with business or success.
Okay.
The first thing I tell them, be totally honest. I mean, we all heard the phrase, honesty is the best policy. But people just mutter it or utter it without real meaning.
Correct.
I really mean it. And I tell them, whatever work you do, just be 100% honest to what you're trying. Try to deliver what you promise. And I really believe in that. A lot of people take shortcuts. You know, they try to fool the customer. This is not the way to grow. You're going to perish because they will come back and hit you. If you've done wrong, if you told lies, if you try to get their money out without delivering what you promised. So any business, this is the bedrock of business. This is the plinth. You can only grow if a base is absolutely strong.
Yeah.
And strength comes from honesty. So I've always been saying this to any entrepreneur who comes, that don't even lie to yourself. Forget lying to anybody else. So that is one of the key mantras as far as I think. There are hundreds and thousands of types of businesses.
Yes.
Whatever is your business, do it well, do it straight.
Thank you so much, Mr. Vikash. What wonderful takeaways from you, sir. Being honest, focusing on growth, believing in networking and helping each other and being there for each other. Thank you so much, Mr. Vikash, for joining us for this panel discussion. And we wish you very best for your future endeavors, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.